coverage is there, effective coverage may be very low because self-employed workers do not take up these options because they are too expensive, they don't think about the barriers are too big. So there is a need to ensure a social safety network that is available to all workers, whatever their employment status. And the recent proposal of the Commission for a Council recommendation is very important in this sense, but we will have to see how it is implemented in practice. To this end, we can have different options. One is to have a universal mandatory public schemes for all workers, whatever, irrespective of their legal status. We can have a minimum level, which is financed through general taxation, that covers basic level of social protection. And then we can have a supplementary level funded through social contribution. This, I think, should be the best solution. However, there are still problems because there are a lot of loopholes and barriers also in Sweden, in countries that already have this type of schemes that makes being entitled to this scheme is often very difficult. It takes a long time, it is very expensive. So we need also to enter into it and see what are the rules governing these schemes. The second type is the one voluntary, mainly voluntary, with private occupational schemes. This maintains the fragmentation we have now with different workers covered in different ways. Here, the representative association and cooperatives may have an important role because through mutualization, they can reduce the individual cost and increase extended coverage for freelance workers. What public policy could do is to support with fiscal incentives, support take-up of these schemes. And also, it is important that the organizations that provide access to this scheme are recognized in the social dialogue and all the institutional places where unions and other type of organizations are involved in the decision-making process, because they are having a crucial role to reduce disparities. The intermediate model could be another option, mandatory minimum public scheme and incentivated voluntary integrative pension schemes. Whatever the choice, there is this problem of transferability across different status and across countries, so there should be a mandatory transferability, and the proposal of the Commission includes this. And it is also important that the systems, the schemes are simplified, and there is information on the importance of being involved in this social protection scheme. Representation, I'm at the end, and social dialogue, we have discussed a lot of this also today. The main message is that both old and new social actors in this field, and also these new forms of representations, are very important to increase the visibility of these workers in policy making, but also are very important because they introduce new forms, new ways to organize the social dialogue, and also may renew labor law, social protection, labor policies, policies for the work-life balances, but also labor taxation and competition policy, because they bring into institutional discussion mechanism the needs of these workers, and the needs of these workers are increasingly representing needs of all workers, because also employees are becoming more and more precarious with less and less income, interruption, discontinuity in their working life, and so on. So it is very important not only for these workers, but for the working of the regulatory mechanism, of policies on many different areas, not only on labor flow and labor policies. This means that the traditional representation and industrial relations mechanism should be revised. We should support a new dialogue between both traditional and non-traditional collective organizations, but also including the different employers, because there is a change also among employers. These workers are increasingly employed by platform owners and also by cooperatives like Smart Bay or Copaname. So there is not the traditional employer. We have new types of employers, and these new type of employers should be involved in the social dialogue so that they become responsible of what it is decided in these places. So the idea is that this new actor and these new forms of representation should be recognized institutionally and be involved in the social dialogue by public institutions through a revision of the framework, industrial relations framework and social dialogue. And here there is the problem of definition of representation. We cannot define representation as with unions using membership. We have to find other ways to define legitimacy and representation. Support for coalition building and collective negotiation, support to territorial social dialogue. We need also to support capacity building across organization. And also we need funding for this organization. So in terms of policies for a new forms of social dialogue, this is a problem. Last slide, we need further research and better data. We studied mainly the worker side and what this new organization is doing. We need to learn more what is the role of new technologies, what is the role of new employers in the evolving of the labor market. And also we need better data. We need to invest in better data in order to be able to provide evidence-based research. Thank you very much.
Of the DG Employment of the European Commission, and Irene